Hi everyone, today we are going to be talking about how to move from software engineering to machine learning. In the past 3 months, I have been reading up a lot about machine learning. Some of the findings have surprised me, so I'll try to break this down into, let's say, 5 important tips. The first thing is not to get lost in all the hype. There's a lot of blog posts, articles that I read, and they're all about the consequences of machine learning. As an engineer who wants to learn something, we are not really too bothered about the consequences right now. Just focus on getting the basic models working. You know, a person who can't write Hello World can't really think about taking over factories. The second point, which I think is quite important, is not to get lost in all the math behind these models, these machine learning models. And I know this is controversial and might sound, you know, completely wrong, but I started from support vector machines, went to quadratic programming, which in turn is based on the simplex method. It's a part of operations research. When I started coding this, it's going to have bugs because we are software engineers. If you want to use a machine, if you want to use a model, you can use it also like an interface, as in you give in some inputs and get some outputs. Yeah, you get some work done instead of understanding how it's working internally. Now, if your purpose is academic or if your purpose is to go through a degree, you have the time to spend understanding this model in depth. But my personal experience is that when I try to learn machine learning this way, I mean, understanding all the mathematics, it's like a rabbit hole. I get lost. Tip number 3, play to your strengths. If you're a data engineer, then consider this to be an extension of the problem that you have. You know, collecting data is something that you do really well. Inferring from it is something that you need to do now, which is what machine learning entirely is. But at least the parts where you collect data and clean it or filter out that data is something that you have been dealing with for a really long time. If you are an algorithm person, then you can start thinking about all the approximation algorithms you have used, possibly in programming contests, possibly in college, to understand how does a machine learning model behave or how do you actually evaluate its performance. So if you play to your strengths and play to things that you already understand, your mind is far more accepting of some new information instead of completely different information. Point number 4 is something that this channel will help you with. It's finding reliable sources. The sources that I use are either company blog posts, let's say Uber, Google, Facebook. What these guys do is they write in terms of software engineering. It makes a lot of sense. Again, it's like playing to your strengths, but also these companies, they don't hype things as much as they possibly could. The second thing is that because it's a practical case of machine learning, there's a lot of decisions that people make before using a particular model instead of, you know, taking a toy problem and then deciding on how to solve it with different ways. Point number 5, which is probably the most important, and although people know it, they don't do it, is coding. You need to implement machine learning algorithms to understand it in depth. Unless you start coding on the terminal, you won't be able to play around with that kind of model. And of course, you won't get the confidence of actually having programmed that machine learning code. Now, there are a lot of courses online for machine learning. A lot of them are quite good also. There's Udacity, there's Kaggle, there's Coursera, but there's one specific machine learning course created by Educator for software engineers. And once I found it, I mean, I didn't waste any time to collaborate with them and make sure that our community gets a discount for this. Machine learning for software engineers is really nice because it moves towards the coding bit initially, and then you can get into the concepts. So there's some results and outputs that you can see while you're making the transition to machine learning. I actually like the way they focus on the pandas library before getting to the complex clustering and other algorithms. The best thing is if you go through this channel and use the coupon code GSML20, then you get a 20% discount. But this is a limited offer, so the first 50 users are only going to get this. And of course, you can guess what GS stands for. So those are the 5 tips I'd like to leave you with to transition from software engineering to machine learning. If you have any doubts or suggestions, you can leave them in the comments below. Of course, you might have your own opinions. You can leave that also in the comments below. If you like the video, then hit the like button. And if you want notifications for further videos like this, hit the subscribe button. I'll see you next time.